I just got two words. Fuck you. Fuck you. Tell my hater, I said. He got banned. He got banned. Run it up, y'all. Yeah, I was trying to get him, Kamar. I was trying to get him. Yeah. No, I ain't messed nothing up, but my mom and them calling. I get tired of that. Every 5 minutes, somebody calling about this. Listen, bitch, because I gave it back to them. They know I got it. And my mama, I'm not going to say no, but shit. They need to keep up with their own shit. Bitch, I got it, bitch. And I'm going to show you that I got it, bitch. You don't know me, bitch. I got it, bitch. Let me show you, bitch. One thing about me, I have it, bitch. I can prove to you, bitch. I got it. Dumbass bitch. Who is that bitch? I just sent my mama $100 right here, bitch. Just sent her $100 just then, bitch. Oh, I got it. Hello? No, I didn't show my account number. But I see my mama and mother all the time, bitch. All the fucking time. All the time, bitch. I ain't gotta show you a motherfucker thing. I ain't gonna show y'all a motherfucker thing. Y'all just
trying to figure out shit. You stupid ass bitches.
It'd be a glitch, but you're very well spoken. I like that. Thanks for coming up. I like how you talk.
She don't need nothing
from me. Shit.
Jenny, no, I never said anything about Pumpkin being jealous. No, I never said that. No, I never said that she was jealous.
And you honestly, you don't realize that that man is crazy?
I mean, I'm seeing it, yeah.
Oh, okay, so what is the issue? Like, it's like every time I go to you and I talk to you and I tell you, yeah, it's not you, it's him. That man talked about you like,
baby, you didn't come to me and tell me nothing. You didn't say nothing to me.
I thought you knew that. Keith was over there dog walking you, dogging me. Do you honestly think this man about to come in this Airbnb and respect anything?
I ain't gonna block my mama for nothing, but the thing about it, I don't mind my mama asking me, but the last minute asking me bullshit because something don't happen. I don't like that. I don't like that. Y'all know how family is. Everybody think because you got money, they can call you all the time. I don't like that. Shit, I don't like that, period. My mama got a husband. She need to be calling her husband. He make a goddamn almost $1 million. You need to be calling him. Don't call me. Shit, I'm sick of that. I'm sick of family. Shit. Always family calling me for shit. I'm tired of it. I'm right up here, bitch. And I'm gonna call him and cuss him out. Watch me. Why did I call my stepdaddy? Why did I call my stepdaddy, y'all? Watch this.
Yeah.
Hey, Bill.
Yeah.
Why you need to keep mama with a damn credit card or something? Because every time mama come here, it's always something. Every time in 5 minutes she done lost her card or whatever, done misplaced her card. Now she gotta give Miss Anna some money. She calling me for money while I'm at work. My line about to go off. I have to work too. I have to make money. And everybody calling me like I'm the richest goddamn person on the earth. Like I said, you need to keep your your wife with a damn card. I'm sick of her calling me every goddamn on week about some shit. I don't know, but mama need an extra card because she always acting like she need a mercy card or something. Because what if I'm dead? What if I'm dead and can't? I'm incapacitated. And I can't get to her. It don't matter. She lost the card, bitch. She misplaced it. You need to put it up. You need to give it to me. What? If she needs some mercy, you need to give it to me. Hand it to me and let me hold it. Yeah, because I can't keep up with her then, and then she gonna act crazy. Oh, I need my money. I need this. Y'all trying to control this and control this and control that. No, she wouldn't. I'm just up for emergency bill in case something happened. You know what I'm saying? And you be out there on that road and all that. This becoming redundant. You know what I'm saying? Every 5 minutes, then when I ask her for the money, back, she would come up with excuse. Yeah, that's why I said you need to give it to me because you know I ain't gonna do nothing with it. You can. But do she have one to get to? Or can you send her money through it? And then you can't keep it then. Because she needed emergency. If you're not here, you wait in New York. You wait up in New York or across the wherever you at. Shit. It don't matter, bitch. I mean, she lost the car. Do you understand? But you know how mama is, Bill. You know how your wife is. So you married her. You know how she is. She misplaced things. She lose things. She got them ugly ass, nephew ass children there. That are doing all kind of shit. Need to go and need to disappear. And all that too. Them nephew, ugly ass grandchildren she got over there running all over her, and she let them do it. Yeah. And all of them pile up there, they don't do a damn thing. But making stuff worse. Them grown, them big buying churn, they ain't doing nothing and walks around in a circle when you say something to them. I be ready to knock one of their ass in their throat. And then when you say something to them, they huffing and puffing up under their damn breath. I be ready to, baby, I almost put fat their head through the goddamn wall over there. I'm sick of them kids. They smart ass mouths and all that, honey. These grown ass churn, they need to be with their mammies. But they need to be with their mammies. They need to be with their mammy. They need to be with their mammy, and mama need to have me back down there. I move out my house and go back to my mama's house. And me, I move out my shit to go down there and take care of mama. I'm sick of that. I'm saying, shit, if she wanna be home, I come down there and live with her until she do whatever. Shit, I can't take this no more. I may well be down there. Shit, them kids got to go. Because they're a headache. The kids, the dogs, and all. She got three other little mutts around there just running around the goddamn house. Them little ugly things. Them little three, three chihuahuas. Now you got three dogs. You got six dogs in the house like this a goddamn any animal kingdom or something. She need to get rid of them. Get them out of there. All right. Yeah, what's going on? To do something with Miss Annie or something like that. She had to do something with Miss Annie and all this. I don't know. I don't know what the hell going on. She ain't really getting there. I was on live. She called me three or four times. I need it because I need it for this. I need it for that. You know. And I need it for this. I need it for that. She had called me three times. My line about to hang up. All right. Bye. Shit. Run up, y'all. Welcome, Ari. You got to come back. Not just it's $100 here, $100 there, $100 there to add up to $233.
My bad, Trina.
She thinks she slick. My mama thinks she real slick. My mama thinks she real slick. She done went to the store. She don't want to spend her money. She trying to spend my money for something. I know what the hell going on. She, my mama, Dorothy, you think you real slick, Dorothy. I know you, you think you real slick.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello. I got questions.
Come on, Kamara. Why you keep coming up here?
Huh?
I keep letting up here. Why she keep jumping in and out as I letting you up?
Can you hear me?
Not in the room, boo.
I'm not.
I ain't talking about her. She keep jumping up here, but she not in the room. She jumping in and out. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
You can hear me?
Yeah.
I'm new to Big O. I was just trying to ask a couple questions.
What is it?
Like, what is it to it? Like, what do you do? Like, in general.
What do I do? I suck dick all day long, bitch. I hoe, bitch. I trick all motherfucking night long, bitch. And I talk about your mama and your grandmama if they got a problem with what I fucking do. Hey, everybody. Everybody. You think you slick? Watch this. Watch this. She ain't gonna answer. She ain't gonna answer now. She ain't gonna answer now, y'all. She don't got $100. She ain't gonna answer now. She don't got the $100. Watch this. She.
Your call has been forwarded.
Now she gonna unallow a bill. About this. About this. About this.
Your call has been forwarded.
She ain't gonna answer, y'all. She ain't gonna answer. Watch this, y'all.
Your call has been forwarded.
And I got two other brothers that got money. Just as much money I do. I'm the oldest, though. Answer the phone! She mad now. She mad I snitched on her. Oh, she mad. I snitched on her. Now watch this. I'm call Bill now. She probably hung up on him.
Yeah.
Hey, what she say? Cause she ain't answering the phone now. She probably mad with me now.
No, she was talking to me. Oh, that's what you talking to me now.
And what she told you happened?
Okay, she had all the cards together. She left them at the house. So Miss Anna take her back to the damn house. She found the food stamp card, but she didn't find the money card.
And what she dropped there?
And then, see, I got to pay Miss Annie to run her around because Saranda ain't goddamn there. See, looks like I put the Jeep in the shop to get the steps where she can climb up in there, right? So I told them before I left, I said, look, I'm going to need somebody to drop me off at work. Dorothy and Saranda said, oh, Miss Bill, I got a car. Go on and take that to work, right?
And why Sharonda is not there?
Huh?
Why the hell is Sharonda not there?
She all with a boyfriend.
Look
here. I told Dorothy, look, I'm going to put all the motherfuckers down and let Snake come down there goddamn stay. But hey, you got to give up how much time you got on left on your leave?
For a minute.
Huh?
For a minute.
Well, you can't go
to
your apartment. You got a lease on
again. I don't have an apartment, Bill. I got a condo.
Huh?
I don't have no apartment.
What, you got a house?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you mean you just can't give it the house right there without, you know, ain't you tied to a lease, though?
Or yeah.
Rent from month to month?
No, a lease.
Huh?
A condo.
Okay, what I'm saying, you pay month to month, or you got a lease on it?
I got a contract on this house. I can't just run out there like this because it's like I'm buying it. I can't just do that. I would have to give up the contract on it. It's like I'm buying from the owner. I'm buying straight from the owner.
How long you been in there?
3 years.
Yeah, that'd be a lot of wasted money if you damn leave. You understand? I mean, how much more time you got to go on the house to own now?
I got another 6 years. Because of what I pay on it. Because of what I pay. Like another 6 years.
Oh, in another 6 years, you know now.
Yeah.
Stay where you at, then, shit. We're gonna have to find somebody that stay with Dorothy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Let me go. All right. No, I'm not renting to own, bitch. It's a contract. I'm buying from straight from the owner, bitch. I'm buying straight from the owner, so I don't owe no mortgage on it, bitch. I put a contract on it. I'm buying straight from the owner, cash house, bitch, cash. No lease to own. No lease to own. It's gonna be my shit. I'm buying straight from the owner. No. I got an option to either get what I invested back out of it. It's like a what's called it? The timeshare shit. Hello?
Trina, Sharonda ain't never there. She might as well go ahead and move on with her boyfriend and you go ahead and take care of your mama.
Yeah.
Yeah. You might as well. Because she ain't never there. She was with her boyfriend.
Yeah.
So she go with her boyfriend and now she can pay bills. Goodbye.
Yeah. You're too much.
Trina?
Yeah.
When you asked Bill for that car, he said,
"Hell to the now." He asked me for no car, bitch. I got my own car. I got my own car. What I asked Bill for a car for? I got my own shit. He said, "Card." I asked him for a card.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
So look, how often a mom have to go places? Y'all don't think maybe y'all could set her up a Uber account just so that no matter what happens, she got a ride to and from where she need to go, even when Sharonda is or is not there?
No, I'm coming down there to take care of my mama because it's a lot of things going undone, you know, undone because yeah. Ain't nobody gonna treat my mama like we gonna do, and that's. And that's my brother.
That's
my brother's dad. That's his ex-wife. You know what I'm saying? And she got a boyfriend now, and all this shit now.
Well, I thought maybe it was because you didn't want to, you know, have to go. That was just an alternative to you going. But if you feel it's best that you go and be there in the home with her, at least being there, you still can pay your rent on your place because living with your mom, you won't have to pay no rent and stuff like that, right?
Nothing.
Yeah, so you could still pay on your place. You just, you know, would only be able to get to go there, like, you know, on the weekends or maybe something like that to get away and get your time for yourself. But, okay, I hope it work out.
Hey, Trina.
But look, it like I'm about to move back with my mama because this becoming to be too much for me.
Trina, can you hear me?
Yes.
Look, if she's on Medicaid, they have a program where you can actually pay a family member to be there with her. And they actually have, like, they have all type of little programs where, like, if she's, she can go to, like, a center for elderly, if y'all want to do that or whatever, they'll pay for it and then transportation and stuff. any doctor's appointments or whatever. Talk to some, talk to, you know, somebody from Medicaid.
Yeah, because
or whatever.
Because she getting food stamps for them two girls, you know, because my mama got custody of my two brother kids, but she not able to take care of herself. They mama need to get custody of them kids back.
I can't
take that. It's just too much. Them kids is from a headache, and they not clean. You know what I'm saying? They come from they other family dirty as a motherfucker. So they don't know what clean is.
Right.
Her mama people is fucked up.
Right. I was just thinking for, you know, as far as somebody being there with her, you know, that's one of the programs that Medicaid do offer, so that you can have
but
a family member.
But I've been telling you the truth, shit, stuff ain't being done the right way.
Yeah, I understand.
Shit, I'm constantly screaming at kids about every day when I go down there to visit my mama and constantly cleaning with 15, 16-year-old kids to clean up.
Right. But just get in contact with somebody from Medicaid. They'll be able to help you, especially with her transportation, anywhere that she needs to go. And then, you know, like I said, if you do find a relative that, you know, you trust to be in the home with her, they will help. You know, they'll pay that person. So just look into it.
I don't give. Kids are grown. Them kids don't do shit. Shit, kids are kids. I'm just being real. Shit, they don't do a goddamn thing. I'ma talk about them. They don't do a goddamn thing. They lazy as fuck. I'm old fashioned, bitch.
What's up, Unc? So that means Miss Dorothy the mama.
Man, let me tell y'all motherfuckers something. Y'all some dumb, ignorant-ass motherfuckers in this damn comments. His mama don't need none of that shit. She need her family to all get together, not just on Trina. She need all her family to get together and go with her to her doc's appointments so they'll know what's fucking going on. Y'all motherfuckers so goddamn stupid. I took care of my mama all the way till my mama died. And I was the only one doing that shit. I had two older brothers. It's hard on you when you got a life and you try to do stuff and you got other motherfucking dumbass siblings that don't want it. But when she died, they all had their motherfucking hands out.
You ain't lying. And then they be the main ones. They be the main ones at the casket crying and all that extra shit.
I wanted to get up so goddamn bad and tell my brothers, y'all, you know what? All y'all kiss my ass. Y'all motherfuckers ain't had nothing to do with mama when she was out here sick and I had to take off work, go on with her to this and that. That shit hard on one person.
It's really hard on one person.
If you ain't never been through that shit, you can't speak on that motherfucker.
Sure can.
That shit. You got other siblings that sitting around enjoying their life. You know, everybody should pitch in. I would want to go to the
She doctor. Right. She right, girl. Calm down, though. But Trina, you can get a check. You can go help take care of your mom and get paid. Don't bitch. Pay. Don't let nobody else get that money. You can get money.
Damn. You dumb bitch.
No, you too loud, girl. Calm down.
I'm driving, bitch. Something that you can't do. I'm in my motherfucking car on my speakerphone, bitch. And you don't like it? Get your ass off. This is a subject. Ain't nobody got time for that bullshit. This shit is hard on one fucking person.
Oh, yes, it is. Oh, but you got to tell me everything hard. And when you go down, and then my mama's stuck in her ways, and I'm telling her the kids don't need to be all day ride. Right, mama, you barely can take care of yourself. And you around here worrying about these damn grown ass, overgrown goddamn children.
And right, when they stuck in their ways and stuff, and you know that they need this and they need that, it's hard. Then on top of you got people around that don't want to pitch in to help and shit. That shit gets on you. I don't give a damn what nobody say.
She can barely take care of herself. You mama, you can barely get around yourself, and you worrying about what these kids doing.
Yeah. And then you got grown, then your mama
And then when I get there, They mumming up on their voice. I chopped the shit out of their motherfucking ass, you son of a bitch. Get your ass out of here, bitch. And they be talking up on their belt like they grown. Like some shit, but I said, get this. Get
Yeah.
I said, I'm going to jail to motherfucker. I be telling mama, mama, that's why I don't come down. That's why I be like, parks my words when I come down. Because I'm going to hurt one of your grandchildren. So you better get, somebody better call, you better, ooh. Mama, how the motherfucker get smaller than they fuck? They get smaller than they goddamn boys, bitch. I be ready to just.
I'm going to get off of here, but I'm going to tell you something, Trina. I see what you said. And a motherfucking black stupid ass bitch goddamn app and in this world. Y'all some stupid motherfuckers. And I mean that shit. Y'all some dumb, ignorant ass bitches that sitting on Section 8, sitting your ass on the goddamn thing, listening to everybody holler on this goddamn app. And then when somebody come in with their opinion, y'all want to talk about y'all loud. No, bitch, we telling the truth. I've been through that shit. I know what Trina's dealing with. I've been through all that shit. If you can't deal with it, then you would never know how I fucking feel. I don't give a damn if it was me, Trina, or anybody. When they shit that I done been through, it's emotions been through that shit. When you the only one doing it, and you got siblings, you got grandkids, all that, and then when they die, they want to motherfucking come around. Man, fuck that.
So I know you don't want to hear this, Trina, but this was told to me. My grandmother passed a couple years ago when she would have my kids over there. The kids keep them going, like gives them something to wake up to, keeps them on their feet when it ain't nobody around them.
Yeah, but
the
kids keep them going, but still, they not doing nothing. They ain't cleaning up nothing. They ain't doing nothing. My mama can't get up and walk in the kitchen like she used to could do and make them kids clean up. She can't do the shit she used to could do because she just had surgery. She just had major surgery on her spine. My mama could have been paralyzed. And all that she barely gets around. Do you understand? My mama is not in a position to be hollering at children. She ain't in a position for that.
Have a good day, honey.
I understand they keep it moving, but she is not in a position for that. She is not in a position for that. She need to focus on taking care of herself.
I wouldn't even say nothing else. Don't give a damn. They on the outside looking motherfucker.
You know what? I'm going down to the clear house. I'm taking my nephew to my sister. I'm going to drop him off at her goddamn house, and she got to deal with him, and she better not call me about a goddamn thing, because your big, fat, lazy, big, fat, nasty ass ain't doing nothing with your goddamn child. You need to get your ass up and take care of your own goddamn child. You mother... I'm going to do a date of reckoning with these hoes. I'm going to do a reckoning with these motherfucking hoes today. I'm sick of them. And then I'm going to take her church... to our boyfriend house. That's what I'm gonna do. When I go down there and I go to acting crazy, and then my mom ain't gonna do nothing but cry. When I kick them all out. When she don't do nothing but cry, she'll get over it. I'm gonna kick them all out.
Come now. I was in a similar situation, Trina, and my suggestion to you, I don't know if you've done this before, it was four of us. I hadn't been married no more than 8 months to my marriage that I'm in now. My mom got sick, she had dementia. She had seizures. She couldn't walk. She couldn't feed herself. So basically, someone had to care for her. I was the only sibling left at home. I gathered with my other siblings, and we had a meeting, and we tried to set up a plan where everybody would rotate. My two brothers were in Ocala. My sister was down south. So that worked about a month. So that feels a lot, and everything was left on me. I was still living in my own home. So once I saw the other did not want to pitch in and do anything, when they didn't do anything, I was my mom's power of attorney over everything, her finances, her care, her home, and everything. So when I started making decisions, what I felt was best for my mom and myself, and to try to maintain my marriage, everybody had so much to say, but nobody was willing to work. Then I said, well, okay, let's try it this way. 3 months out of a year, let's rotate and keep
mama. That's what the same thing was last time. We was all at the, hold on, hold on. We was out of, I'm the oldest, and we was out of the hospital. The hospital nurse came because mama was not responsive at the time when she went in surgery because she had an infection. You know, the infection had made her not respond because that's the reason why they had to go in and do the spine surgery and do all this for her to be able to walk again. When I get to the goddamn, make a long story short, I get to the hospital. My brother, my youngest brother, and my other brother, sister-in-law, and my other brother up there, talk about, Stanker coming, they call me Stanker. Oh, he coming up here, and he trying to make, tell my mama, he trying to make decisions, without us, and telling us you're going to put you in a rehab center and not let you go home and this. I said, look here. When I get there and the people asking me, talking about, we need all four of y'all to come down or your stepdad. My stepdad said, I don't want to have nothing to do with that, y'all. You know, when it comes to our medical stuff, he left it up to us. He said, well, you handle it. So he gave me the reign to handle it. So when I get down there, nobody wants to participate. My brother stay in Tampa and the other one stay in Tallahassee. So I said, y'all ass gonna come down here every motherfucking week or every weekend, every other day to come down here to see about mama. If y'all not, shut the fuck up. You know what I'm saying? Y'all ain't got nothing to say about how mama doing. So I signed them goddamn papers and I took over and did this, and now I'm power turning over all shit now. I'm power turning over everything. But the thing about it, they didn't want to take the responsibility, but they had so much to say about me making decisions for my mama. I'm mama, my oldest. I'm gonna make the best decisions. Y'all ain't gonna do shit. Y'all the youngest. Y'all know what the fuck to do with mama. Y'all know what the fuck how mama is and everything mama say. I'm the first child, so I know everything. That was me and mama was close. Me and my mama was real close, like Ace New King. Cause I know everything. You know. How kids, you know, they are my mama's children, and they don't know everything about mama like I do. You know how to tell her no, she can't have this. They're not gonna put their foot down. They're gonna let mama run. Mama, they ain't gonna know. You know, like the best thing for her. When mama go to Rampin and Raven, talk about she ain't gonna do this. Yes, she is. We going to the hospital. Yes, she is. We going to the hospital. Yes, I'm gonna get her. The people go out to, they have to scrap you down to go to the hospital because she didn't even want to go to the hospital. If we didn't even get my mama to the hospital, my brother and them, I was home. I went to Atlanta. And I don't know what I was in Atlanta for at that particular time. But I went to Atlanta. So when I get home, my mother in the bed sick. I said, I'm saying, mama, are you okay? I get some mama real, yes, unresponsive, talking out of head, all kind of shit. You know what I'm like? Now, what's going on, mama? Y'all see some mama declining like this, and y'all ain't sent her to the hospital? I said, my mama going to the hospital today, so she got up. I made her get into, I ain't going to the hospital. I don't care what you say. I said, oh, you going to the hospital today. So when she got on the toilet stool, so the police came in the goddamn house. I called the police. Police came in the house. Ma'am, we gotta take you to the house. You got your fever's high, your blood pressure low. You could be threatening your life in danger. Oh, I ain't going nowhere. She was just rapping and raving. Oh, we can't make her go nowhere. My brother, so she going today. She going today on my dead body. Oh, my dead body. So when we found her. Got the officers to get her in the ambulance. She was cussing and fussing. No. The normal thing. Oh, you don't know what you're talking about. She gets to the hospital. The hospital said we had not got her there in time. She would have been dead the next morning.
Well, see, that's why you have all power in your hand. As long as you power of attorney, they can rant and rave as much as they want. Keep those papers where you can put your hands on them. So when they want to try to call the police or whatever, they look at that paper.
She got infection in her blood. The infection was in her blood. The infection had got so bad from her spine where she had an abscess. She had an abscess on where they had surgery on her neck because she had surgery on her spine before. It got an abscess on her neck. She had a C3 and cysts on both of her neck, and it got so bad that it, it had got in her bloodstream, and they were saying that if it had started affecting her organs, she would have been just septic. You know what I'm saying? And she would have died from the effects.
Well, you need to do what you have to do. You say you're the power of attorney, Stephen. You shouldn't have any problems. And if you have problems, as long as you have that power of attorney paper in your hand and it can be presented to any law enforcement, no sibling, no neighbors, no nothing will be able to overrule that. And sometimes you have to go that route in order to take care, whether it's a mother, father, sibling, whatever.
And the Lord, thank God for me. Because and me paying attention to my mama, because the doctor said, if it was not for you, son, your mama would have been dead. Been dead because people not paying attention to her illness. He said, thank God that you pay attention to your mama's illness and the way she reacts to stuff, because she would have been dead.
Yeah, somebody just made in the comment says, but you still have legal issues. That's why when you become a power attorney, you just basically take it over everything. You make decisions on medical, financial, living conditions, situations, or whatever. You have that paperwork, and nobody can come in front of you. I know what I'm talking about, and I live in Florida too, Trina. And I had no problems because some of my siblings, they were upset. But when I presented those things to them, it was nothing they could do about it. So because I'm the baby, and I was there. I moved out of my home when I was 8 months just into a marriage to take care of my mom. And I took care of her about 6 years until her medical conditions got beyond what I could do. Then the hard decision I had to make was to put her in a nursing home. But I was there with her 24/7 and stuff. Put your foot down. Do what you need to do. Take care of your mom. And the ones that's in the bike ride yelling, talking about this and that, if you ain't doing shit, you can't tell me shit. Simple as that. Mm-hmm.
So with the power of attorney thing, you still need a will, because a lot of people don't understand that power of attorney ends at death.
Yeah, okay. I got a will.
They try to come to the funeral home talking about they got power of attorney. Power of attorney ends at death. So a lot of people don't understand that. So folks still need to have a will, and they still need to have their affairs in order. Just want to let everybody know that.
Y'all, I gotta go, y'all. I gotta go. I gotta go. I gotta go. I gotta go.